We are?
Yep.
Second house has been recorded. Feet, the belt, silver harnesses are on. Fuel shuttle valve is on. Radios, electrical, transponders. Circuit breakers, check in.
Hello?
Therapeut is off. Mixer is fuel rich.
No.
Primary is required.
No. It's in the box there. Yeah, we're going to go. It's very light.
The third time, though, I'm not going to push it in.
Yeah.
The second time? The fuck? It's not going all the way in.
No, leave it out, all the way out.
No, I'm saying eventually I got to lock it in.
Yeah, you got to find a little hole.
I got to find a little hole. That's very funny. That's very funny. That's very funny. The little hole's right there, it's not locking in. Okay, but I gotta pull it out though, right?
You eat your weenies in the morning?
What does that mean?
Weenies, you know, like breakfast.
I don't eat cereal. Primer is left out, so I'll open a cord. I'm not going to wear these fucking things. I'll leave my tactical first. Fuck. Saddle's open a quarter of an inch. Master switch is on. Brakes are on. Rotating beacon is on. Well, pressure's in the green, flaps are up.
Electricals are on. Okay. One moment, please. Tuesday, November 24th, 2015, 8:26 a.m. I had the flaps down and I put them up. Say what? There's no way to put the flaps down below 40. Oh, below 40 degrees, but okay, so how do I check my flaps? Don't check the flaps. I see. I see. Funny how all the stuff you have to know to fly a plane.
Advise this contact, give him permission, Papa. Chicago Executive Airport Information, Papa, 1352 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 5, mist, skies clear, temperature minus 3, dew point minus 4, altimeter 3033, GPS runway 16 approaches news, landing runway 16, departing runway 34, notice to airmen, runway 624 closed,
one moment,
runway 1230 closed, area 3 ramp closed.
You don't do that because of the, it drains the battery.
Oh, really? I wasn't aware of that.
Ice and snow on runway 624 and 1230. Use caution. Advisors contact, give information, Papa.
It's
going to be a pretty information, Papa. 1352 Zulu. Wind calm. Visibility 5. Mist. Sky is clear. Temperature minus 3. Dew point minus 4. Altimeter 3033. GPS runway 16 approaches and use. Landing runway 16. Departing runway 34. Notice to airmen. Runway 624 closed. Runway 1230 closed. Area 3 ramp closed. Runway 16 glide slope out of service. Patchy ice and snow on runway 624 and 1230. Use caution. Advisors contact, give information, Papa.
Okay, so I'm going to request a northeast departure. We're going to go over the lake, we're going to play and come back, some touch and goes. You concur?
Yep.
Fabulous.
That's kind of rough, huh?
Whoa, don't go beyond 1500, come on.
Why not?
Because I got my brakes on, then you're gonna.
I got the brakes on. I'm the pilot in command right now. I tell you, wait. I'm watching. I'm making sure this plane is okay. I hear it rough.
Why can't you go above 1500? Bozeman radar vectors, Mikey, as filed.
What?
Maintain 3000.
I don't want the plane to just go.
No, it's not gonna go.
Okay.
Believe me, I've 35 years.
120.
It's not gonna go nowhere.
All right, I have
me on the controls.
I have ATIS. I'm gonna request a northeast departure. Runway 16 and 34. There's no wind, so it's gonna be either one or the other. So it doesn't matter. But for a northeast departure, he'll probably go to runway 34. This guy's in the way, or at least he's going to get out of the way. So if they give me runway 34 and I can't get out of here, what do I do?
Just wait. He just jumped in his car. He's about to leave.
Yeah, should I wait for him to move, or?
Well, you could call. You could call, and he's going to tell you what to do. He hears ground control also.
Oh, he does, huh?
Yes.
Fabulous.
He hears the ground control. If ground control might tell you make a right, take Delta to Echo. And you don't know which way they're going to go. They could give you 2-4. When's that come? But they could give you any runway, really.
Executive ground. Signature.
Delta to Echo. How the hell are we going to go with Delta to Echo? Delta's right here.
Or Bravo to Echo.
Bravo to Echo.
That'll probably give you 2-4 since it's so close.
2-4 is closed.
It is? Okay.
Bravo.
You want to go back to ATIS?
No, go ahead.
Signature.
Come on, man.
Forward equipment intel.
One moment, please. Executive ground, Cessna 6001 Golf at Area 2, requesting northeast departure with ATIS Papa.
Cessna 6001 Golf, executive ground, runway 16, taxi via Bravo Echo Kilo Cross 24.
Runway 16, via Bravo Echo Kilo Cross 24, 01 Golf. Let's go.
Okay, now it sounds good. You see, something was going on there. But now I hear that hum.
That
the way it should be.
Are ready?
Yeah.
Gonna check our brakes.
It took a little while for it to warm up.
Check your brakes. Fabulous.
All right.
The wheels to go in the snow. You got the cabin heat in?
Cabin heat is on. I'm holding off with the cabin air until
excellent.
Until we start warming up a little bit.
Bravo, Echo Kilo Cross 24.
Down 1000 RPM.
No windsock, the windsock's down. No Those flashing lights right there mean what?
I mean there's a runway there.
Oh, how nice. Nice to point that out.
Runway 312 is there.
Which runway?
Runway 3012.
Oh, okay. Bravo with Coquille across 24. I don't see anything coming our way. Too far. That way. I don't see anything coming our way. And we're on Kilo. I'm getting a disconnect between the compass and the heading situation indicator. I fixed it during the pre-flight, and now it's being a little bit more still off.
All right, what runs this thing?
The vacuum pump.
Okay. So, and what's going through the vacuum pump? There's a filter. There's an air filter.
Is there? I didn't know that.
Yeah. So when you're in low RPMs and stuff like that, it's going to act erratic. It's not going to be, it's going to process.
I see.
So, it's not going to act the way it should at low RPMs. So that's why you have to set that and check it every 15 minutes. If you fly 87 Juliet Alpha, you got to check it every 5 minutes.
Right.
So every plane is different because it processes a lot.
I see.
So don't think that it's going to stay there throughout your entire flight. Watch the ice. There's a lot of ice over there.
Letter 315.
And it's called precession. It'll move every 15 minutes. That's normal. Watch that patch of ice there.
Okay. Cabin doors and windows closing latch. Thank you very much. Flight controls check movement. Okay. Elevator trim set to takeoff position. Throttle at 1700. Brakes are full on. Engine instruments and suction in the green. Magnetos. First to right. Then to left. RP, check for RPM drop. Meter check by splitting the master, but not the battery. Battery's being charged up.
Let's see, I heard that. Let me see this.
Yeah.
It's going back out. Yeah, a little carb ice.
We have carb ice?
You had a little bit. It went down below 15?
Yes.
Signature 6, Yankee Delta Cross 1-2.
Direction
is fuel truck 7.
There's good weather for carb ice here. Anytime you got frost on the wings, you got to get carb ice.
Signature 7.
Battle returns to idle back to 1,000. Okay.
Letter 70 November, Juliet Quest, good morning. MQS, radar vectors, Mobley.
Radio set the tower. Fuel shut off, confirm a down position. Mixture confirmed fuel rich. Transponder 1200 on altitude. We are on altitude. Landing lights on. Flaps are up. Alright, we're going to northeast. Do maneuvers over the lake. You concur?
That's right.
Fabulous. Here we go. Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf at 16 pad, ready for departure.
Cessna 6001 Golf, Executive Tower, Cessna on the rolls and left closed traffic. Turn left northeast, 16, clear for takeoff.
16, clear for takeoff, northeast. Thank you, 01 Golf. I'm go right.
Yeah?
I'm heading out. Right? He was clearance.
Didn't he say clear?
He did, yes. He said a lot of stuff that confused the hell out of me. I gotta be careful of this patchy junk here. Junk. And he said turn left, right?
So left to the northeast.
Yes.
Okay. But there's a traffic rolling on the runway. Clear for takeoff. Turn left and north.
Should be a nice day. No winds. All right. Are you ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Rotate. Damn birds.
Cessna 7 Uniform Delta, runway 16, clear to land.
7 Uniform Delta, clear to land, runway 16, we'll be returning to Hangar 6.
Roger.
Okay, heading situation indicator and compass are pretty much okay, or they were at least. Not anymore.
You can't check. When you're in a climb or a descent, you can't check this. It's only on level flight. In straight and level flight, that's when you can check the compass.
Heading towards the northeast. Wow, the runway, the field looks different with snow on it. Different. It'll be tougher to see too. Feet. Leveling. actually still climbing. Should I reduce my RPMs or my trim tab?
What are you going to climb to?
I only want to stay at 1800 until we get over the lake.
If you want to stay here, then you got the power at 24 already, so all you have to do is trim it now.
Trim it?
Yes.
All right, I see that tower straight up ahead. That's got to be, one moment. Well, we're heading to the northeast. So my gut reaction would be to say that's, Port Sheridan.
Cessna 7, you're from Delta, taxi to 16 by Kilo.
7 uniform, Delta needs to return to Hangar 6.
Yep, sorry about that. Lima 3, Yankee Delta, cross 12, my frequency.
Lima, exiting at Lima 3, Yankee Delta, clear to cross runway 12 to Hangar 6. Have a good day.
Trying to find that tower that's 7 miles east of the airport. 7 miles east, that one tower, that landmark. It's a big tower. I'm going to make a little bit of a turn to take a look and see. I don't see it on this side. I don't see it. Remember that tower that's exactly 7 miles east?
I see it.
You see it. See it. I don't. Oh, right there. Is it that tower over there? There?
That's right.
That's it. That's the tower. Okay, so that's nice to know. That's nice to know. Okay, so I'm going to head back towards the northeast. And again, I keep gaining altitude. I don't like that. Port Sheridan, right there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. As soon as I cross Port Sheridan, I'll hit what, 3,000 feet?
Yeah. Once you go over the lake.
Ticket to Tower Scott 233 at Victor, inbound with Papa over Lake Zurich for full stop attack to that.
Cessna 238 Victor, Executive Tower, report 2 out for runway 16.
Report 2 after 16, 38 Victor.
You brought your the flaps down and then you brought them back up?
Not during the runoff. My pre-flight, I put the flaps down, and then when we got back in and I was going through the checklist, it's flaps up, and that's what I did, flaps
that
up.
That was after the engine was started? Or before the engine started?
Whatever the checklist said.
Because I didn't see them down when I came to the airplane.
The flaps were down. I always check the flaps. The flaps were down.
So when I got to the airplane, the flaps were down?
Yes, of course.
And then after you started it, you brought the flaps up?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, because that would have drained it double. If you would have brought the flaps up before you started the engine, it would have drained it twice. And these batteries, they die out quick. They're small little things like that.
Yeah.
They're only good for starting the engine. Hey, you don't see the horizon out there.
So that's right, Victor. Be advised the Challenger will be departing runway 34 to the north.
You looking up our departing traffic on 34. Great, Victor.
I won't break the 500 vertical feet a minute, then we should be okay.
This is prime weather
this
for icing.
This is 901 Tower, you up?
For a carb ice. Because you got that haze, and it's cold. Okay, so be careful with that car. You have to have that carb heat on.
Tower, just be 901, try to go.
Speed 901 opposite direction, Cessna 5 Northwest, turn right, heading 360, runway 34, clear for takeoff.
Okay, right to 360, have to take off, and just speed 901, clear for takeoff.
Alright, give me a climbing turn to the left, towards the shore.
What degree?
Towards the west.
Now, how steep?
Like that, that's good.
See what?
This is good. I just don't want to get too far away from the shore. If this engine goes out, there's a carb ice. I want to be within gliding distance.
Okay, coming up to 3,000, got to level off. Heading due west.
All right.
So, slow flight.
Slow flight.
Slow flight is as follows. Carb heat.
Victor, do you have the jet off the departure into 34?
Carb heat will be on.
I do not yet, Victor.
Carb heat will be on. 1500. Flaps 10 degrees. Here we go.
No, I do, Victor. Got been
full flaps.
Victor behind the Challenger, runway 16.
Bring him down in increments.
One moment, sir.
On the 16.
Carb heat is on.
Behind the Challenger.
Engine at 1500.
Cessna is a mile and a half, heading your left 17.
Trim tabbing.
Climbing well above them. Contact.
Ooh.
Safe flight.
1500, okay. Full flaps?
Yep.
Yes, sir, full flaps.
Look at it, you're turning. Level.
Okay, we're at 3,000 feet. Trim tab should be set up. Trim tab, nose up. I'm losing altitude. Nose up. I'm still losing altitude. Nose up. Ooh, pitch down. Nose up.
No, add a little power.
Add a little power.
You're pitching down and you're descending, right? So add some power, right there. That's where you want to be. That's going to hold it.
Okay.
Right there.
More power?
A little bit more. All right. You should be like at 22. That's good. Right there.
All right.
All right, that's holding it right there.
Slow flight?
Huh?
Slow flight?
This is slow flight.
Right, you want me to make a turn?
All right, yeah, give me a turn to the right.
To the right, so...
Don't wobble it around too much. If you wobble it around, you're going to cause a lot of, you could stall it. So don't wobble it. Oh, this is real gentle. That's maintaining that altitude. Good.
Now what?
All right, give me a turn to the left. Just look. All you got to do when you're turning, just look. No, you don't have to lift the wing up too much. Just a little bit.
Yeah.
Just like that, and just make your turn. Very gentle.
I'm trying to make sure I'm coordinated.
Yeah, give me a turn all the way down towards the lake again, towards the east. All right, just fly out for a little bit.
Only lost about 25 feet on that one.
But once you got established, now you're right, you're there, right?
Right.
So, maintain this out.
The ball is in the center, I got a little bit more right rudder.
Yeah, but you're turning. You're putting left rudder now. Okay, you're cross control, put a little right rudder. Right there. Okay, give me a turn to the north.
Southwest King Air 54 Charlie Hotel.
Okay, talk to me about a stall. Power off stall.
King Air 54 Charlie Hotel.
Power off stall would be, we're basically in the configuration. I'm going to be.
Report 10 out.
I'm already full flaps and fit, and I got to drop my RPMs to 1500.
Now you're going to take it all out. You're going to take all the power out.
All the power is going to come out.
Yeah, just like if you're on short final.
And then I'm going to trim tab when my nose is up.
No, you're not going to trim tab nothing.
Nothing.
You're just going to take the power out. You're going to come down. Right?
Point the nose down.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh. And then what else? Wait, I'm not done yet.
Okay.
What else are you going to do? What are you going to do? Okay, you're pointing your nose down. Then what are you doing? Then you're going to pitch up, right?
Right.
You're going to pull back, pitch up slowly, and then it's going to stall.
Yes.
And then you're going to add full power right away. You're not going to hesitate. You're going to bring that nose down below the horizon.
Right.
Just below the horizon there, and then you're adding full power simultaneously. And then you're recovering, right? You're coming up, and you're bringing the flaps up.
All right. From this configuration, right. I'm going to pull the throttle full out. And then I'm going to pitch the nose down gentle.
Right.
And then, once I'm established in that down position, I'm going to pull back until I hear the stall horn. Then I'm going to pitch back down and full power.
Yep.
Here we go.
All right.
Okay.
You're okay. You lost 100 feet.
Okay.
Okay, start pitching up.
Gentle,
pitch
gentle.
Pitch up, pitch up. All right, there's the stall horn.
Yes.
Bring the nose down. Full power. Come on. Operator heat goes in, and then one notch of flaps. Now you want to start climbing out. You don't want to hit the ground, okay?
Cessna 3, Victor, left.
Start climbing out.
Your choice.
Then bring up another notch.
Take up on 1-6. Thank you.
Looking at your airspeed, it's starting to increase, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you want your nose right on the, right just straight where it's at, right on the horizon.
Right.
Now it's coming up. Give yourself another notch of flaps. Yeah, trim it out all along, okay? Okay, you're coming up 70. You bring up your last notch of flaps at 70. All right. Now a power on stall. Okay, we're not going to go through the full stall. We're just going to go right on the intimate side of it. Okay.
All right. Let me hit 3,000 first. Okay, so power on stall, I'm going to, again, carb heat on 1500,
yeah.
And then I'm going to,
you slow down because you're getting close to what you're going to have. Slow down. All right.
It'll be carb heat out 1500 RPMs, and then I'm going to power on stall. Then I'm going to pitch up until I hit pitch up and increase the throttle as I pitch up.
All right.
So car P'd out. Throttle at 1500.
Then you're going to increase it to 22, okay? I don't want you to increase it all the way.
Okay, so now what I'm going to be doing
now
is...
Now you're just going to wait till... You're going to maintain this altitude, right?
Right.
And you're going to wait till the airspeed's down to takeoff speed, okay?
Okay. Tower. The 55 or knots, okay. 65.
You'll be number 20, Cessna. He's in the pattern.
There's the Waukegan right there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Keep it up. Keep it up right there. You don't want to push it. All right. You're at 55 now. Carburetor heat goes in.
Power on.
Power to 22. Put it up to 22. And pitch up. Pitch up. A little right rudder.
70. Holding short. Runway 16 ready to go.
Losing speed.
There's the house horn.
Shh.
All right, full power, pitch down.
All right. I'm gonna make a turn to the right so I can
get out of here.
Take off Cessna left numbers.
All right, let's go to what? Let's go to executive. I want you to do some touch and goes. I want to see how you do on those because last time you didn't bring the flaps up, and
I
that's
know.
Dangerous.
I know.
So we'll do a couple touch and goes, and I want to do the option because I want you to taxi back. And I want to see what you do with the carburetor heat and the flaps. Because you went all the way to the tie down and you didn't bring any of that up.
Sorry about that.
No, it's not sorry. Don't tell me sorry. It's the examiner is going to see that and he's going to fail you.
Okay.
You know, it's nothing on me. Well, it will be on me because he's going to see that and teach you. So, and you got to get into that habit.
I gotta lose some altitude.
All right, I want you to take me back to executive. I want you to find it, whichever means possible. You don't have to lose too much that fast. You know, just slow down a little bit.
Whoa! Fuck!
Yeah, tear the wings off this plane, man. They're in the caution range.
Executive Tower 3 at Victor, heading back to Hangar 6.
Sorry about that.
Roger.
Airport Charlie Hotel, just continue eastbound, join the final, I'll have a sight.
Alright, let me,
what?
Okay, you lost your engine, what are you going to do?
Pitch for best glide, which is 65.
Yeah.
I gotta find a place to land. Out in the water.
That's nice.
I'm gonna have to land somewhere here. I see nothing but trees, though. Yeah. I see a spot over there. If I can reach that.
How about right here? Look, you got two fields right here. Two nice fields.
Victor.
Yeah.
Down
here?
Right here, right? You see that one right there?
Yeah. Okay, so I'll circle around then.
Circle around this way.
Currently 16, major altitude maintained 2,000 feet.
You're gonna like enter the pattern. You're gonna go around like that, all right? But you're gonna simulate it as like enter the pattern. 65. You're not nowhere close to your. What's the best glide?
65.
Okay, you're nowhere close to that. Don't steepen too much. Right here. Put the nose down. Don't want to go too much. All right, what else are you going to do?
I got to see if I can, let's see, my fuel thing is on. Mixture's full in. I would, at this point, try and restart the engine.
All right. All right, you think you're going to make that field?
Not this one here. That
Maybe
one
that
there.
One? Okay.
That one there I'll make.
Okay, what would you do? Add flaps and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Maybe slip it. Okay, you made it. All right, carburetor heat goes in, full power. Stuff go out of here.
I wouldn't say I made it.
Well, you could bring all your flaps, dump all your flaps, right? And you could slip the plane.
Auger 5.
You'll lose a lot of altitude when you slip the plane, right?
Yeah.
Traffic. Still holding.
550, Charlie.
I'm trying to find that tower, so I know I'm 7 miles east.
How about this one? You can't find it this way? Are you always going to go to that tower?
There's the church.
Okay. Well, how far is the church?
4 miles.
No.
7 miles.
8 miles.
8 miles.
Okay, and what else do you see out there? Slow down a little bit, you're at 20. Okay, you got the church, right?
The steeple's right here with the water tower.
What else do you see out there? See anything else that might give you an indication of where you're at?
I'm going southwest. I mean, I'm going to have to...
See those two black buildings right there?
Atlantic and maintenance frequency.
There's two black buildings. You see that smoke that's out coming in?
Yes. Oh, those guys. Yeah, I see them.
All right. That's the best landmark in the wintertime.
Because right.
They're black and they stand out in the the white background with
yes.
the snow.
Yes.
Okay, and the Wesson is right south of that. So you know you're 2 miles, that's 2 miles south, north of the field.
Okay, right now we're 8 miles.
Yeah.
Okay, 8 miles.
So what are you going to do? Okay, I'll let you do what you have to do. What are you going to do?
I'm going to basically call in the tower and tell them I'm 8 miles northeast requesting touch and goes.
Okay, with what?
Into the pattern.
All right, you're just going to go in there and you're going to say, do you have information?
Oh, fucking a stick, okay.
Altimeter, 3033. GPS runway 16 approach in use. Landing part of runway 16. Notice the airman.
Are you going to continue inbound? Or are you just going to circle? You can circle right here because you know where you're at, right?
230 closed.
I'm going to continue.
All right.
Area 3 ramp is closed. Advise contact information, KBEC.
KBEC. Yep. We'll listen to it one more time, then I'll call in.
Chicago, executive information, KBEC, time 1452, Zulu observation. Wind calm, visibility 5, mist, sky clear, temperature minus 2, dew point minus 2. Altimeter, 3033. GPS runway 16 approach in use, landing part of runway 16. Notice the airman, runway 16 glide slope out of service, runway 624 and runway 1230 closed. Area 3 ramp is closed, advise contact information, KBEC.
Okay, how far are you?
7 miles.
785 Sierra Charlie, contact
85 Sierra Charlie, slow.
Chicago Executive Cessna 6001 Golf, 6 miles northeast inbound for to stay in the pattern with the option. So 01 Golf. 8 is Quebec.
Cessna 6001 Golf, exact tower kind of pattern work.
Touch and goes.
Touch and goes.
So 01 Golf, runway 16, clear touch and go, left traffic until advised.
Runway 16, touch and goes, left traffic, 01 Golf. Airport's right there.
Those are the landmarks right there that you got to look at for.
Okay.
The tower is okay, but you're not anywhere close to that. Unless you want to waste time looking for that.
Those two black buildings, what are they?
That's those are office buildings. I think they're Caremark.
Oh.
And some, it's they got different off, companies
and,
in there.
And the white building's the Westin?
Yeah.
Okay. That's at the point 2 miles out, I'm going to hit pattern altitude.
Yeah, by the time you get there, you should be at pattern altitude. And if you want to line it up, I would go like right on the right side of the Westin and just fly like that and then come in. The longer the final, the better. If we cleared you to land, I would get up here and start coming in on the long final. The longer the final, the better the landing. Especially on a crosswind.
Touch and go, right?
Gonna go touch and go. They'll do the first one touch and go, and then we'll do some full stop landings.
Heat in. Throttle 1700. Flaps 10 degrees. Degrees.
That's the 353 senior form. Tower, how much more time do you need?
353 senior form, we need about a minute and a half.
That's 30 degrees.
Would you like us to cross over the runway after the traffic and all that?
Pointing down.
That's the 3-3 form, cross runway 1-6 to the 1-6 pad for your run-up.
Cross runway 1-6 for the 1-6 pad, 3-5-3-3 uniform.
Great. I got plenty of room. Shh. Carpeed in, flaps are up. Full throttle.
Alright. What has to be done?
Better. Rotate. I'm going to ask him for a full stop.
No, you asked him. You already told him you want the option, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you got the option, you could get off the runway whenever you want. You have the option of a touch and go or a full stop landing.
Okay, but the next one you may do a full stop.
You're going to do a full stop on this one.
And then I'm going to head what to? What am I going to do after that?
You're going to take off again.
I'm going to do a full stop on the runway.
No, pull out. Go full stop.
Taxi golf when able, start the left crosswind.
It's called a full stop.
When able, left crosswind. 0-1 golf.
It's called a full stop taxi back.
All right. So when I touch ground, I'm going to taxi to the 16 pad.
No, you're going to taxi back to the runway, to the beginning of the runway.
I'm confused.
You haven't done this. You never did a full stop taxi back.
I'm sure I must have. I'm gonna hit.
That's at 367 Executive Tower. Turn left heading 040 within a mile, maintain 2,000 feet, runway 1-6 lift takeoff.
I'm gonna land.
Okay, let's turn.
And then go back to the end of the runway.
2,000.
You're gonna go down and taxi with Kilo. And you're gonna go back to the beginning of the runway. Oh, okay, got you. Yeah, we did that. You and I did that.
And turning within the mile.
The reason we're practicing that is because you forgot your flaps. You taxied all the way back to the runway. I mean, to the tie down with your flaps down.
Shame on me for doing that.
Yeah, there's a after landing checklist that you got to follow, and you didn't follow that. Where's your checklist?
It's here, it's under my leg.
All right. I want you to follow everything that says on there.
Do I have to? I don't have to tell him, right?
No, he's gonna see that you got off the runway, and he's gonna tell you. He has to give you instructions. You have to cross the whole short line, right?
Yes.
And you gotta stop. You gotta wait till he tells you what to do.
Okay. Yeah. That plane's taking off.
In the meantime, while you're waiting, you're cleaning up your plane. You're cleaning your flaps up.
I'm going to turbulence departed citation, runway 1-3, touch and go.
He's talking to you.
To me?
Yep.
01 golf, touch and go. Okay. I'm going to beam the numbers. Carp heat is on.
That jet 357, Connash guy departure.
So jet 357, have a good day.
1700. Flaps 10 degrees.
And this will be a full stop taxi back for 01 golf.
Sorry about that, thank you. Getting ready to make my turn. Oops. 10 degrees of flaps.
Skyhound 353, the uniform, holding short of runway 16, departure to the north, ready for takeoff.
Cessna 3, uniform, hold short of runway 16, landing traffic.
Hold short of landing traffic, 353, the uniform.
All flaps. Two reds, pointing down, lining it up, three reds, getting ready to pull back, throttles full out. Shh, we got plenty of room, we got plenty of room, plenty of room. Okay, heartbeat in, flaps are up.
No.
What?
You don't have to, that's only for a short field takeoff. When you get off, then you bring all that stuff up.
Sorry.
I mean, that would be good for short field landing. That's what you have to do.
Okay. I stay with tower, I don't switch the ground.
Pass the line.
Now
you gotta wait till he comes back to you.
Tower, not ground.
No, just wait right here.
All right.
Look at your checklist.
I got it.
01 golf, taxi back via Kilo.
Taxi back via Kilo, 01 golf.
Alright, look at that.
That's 3-3, runway 16, clear for takeoff, turn right northwest.
Clear for takeoff, turn right northwest, 353 uniform.
After landing flaps are up, carpet is off. Transponder on standby?
Yep.
Contact 01 golf, right here, we're gonna wait there, give way to the jet now on Kilo.
We'll give way to the jet, 01 golf.
He's handling ground. He's doing ground for you.
Okay, that's nice. Now he wants me to go back to the 16 pad.
Right, tower, Challenger,
he said taxi back.
We're about miles out for 16.
Challenger 602, November Papa, Executive Tower, runway 16, clear to land, stay parking.
Clear to land, we're going to park at signature this morning.
Now this jet, he's going to take off, and if they clear us to take off right behind them, how are you going to take off? Are you going to take off before him or after
him? Before he took off, because then if I do it after, then I got his turbulence.
Yeah.
So I got to get off before.
Right.
And I'm not going to follow him until he hits the pad, right?
You can start. You can start real gentle. Real slow. About this distance right here from him.
Sure.
November Juliet, we'll be ready at 1-6.
We are 7-0 November Juliet, Executive Tower, Cessna off departure, and be at a right turn. Turn left heading 040, then mile and maintain 2,000 feet, and runway 1-6, clear for takeoff.
I noticed that
2,000, left turn 040, runway 1-6, clear for takeoff, 0 November Juliet.
I noticed that as I'm landing today, I'm getting 4 whites. What am I doing wrong?
They're too high.
Yes, I know that. Thank you very much. I'm not going into the pad, right?
No. He's already cleared the takeoff, so.
Right.
What you're going to do is you're going to go up to the whole shoreline, wait, and then call him up, tell him you're ready for takeoff. Why don't you check your plane out, make sure you're ready for takeoff.
Carpet and flaps are up, yeah. Whoa. How many more touch and goes you want to do?
I prefer doing full stop taxi backs.
Yeah, we'll do full stop taxi back. Do I have to tell them that?
Oh, you got the option.
Okay.
Says 01 Golf, caution wake turbulence for the departed Learjet. Challenger's 4 mile final, runway 1-6, clear for takeoff.
Runway 1-6, clear for takeoff, 01 Golf.
Alright, you ready to go?
Sir, yes I am.
Oh, no, you're not.
I'm not, why not?
Because you don't have your transponder on alpha.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay, yes, there we go, thank you. I think I'm ready to go now.
Now you're ready.
Yes, thank you.
So you just check, do a flow check. Flaps up,
yes.
Make sure you're in, carburetor heat off, and then you come up here, check that.
Did I ever mention that I'm really, really glad one of us knows what the hell
we're doing? 0 November Juliet, contact Sky Departure.
Departure now, 0 November Juliet, good day.
Did I ever mention that I'm really glad one of us knows what the hell's going on here?
Oh, you never did.
I'm really glad one of us knows how to fly this fucking thing. Okie dokie artichokey. Lined up good enough. He's gone. There's going to be no turbulence. Are you ready?
Ready.
Rock and roll to a full stop, the same as before. Here we go.
Rotate,
my friend. Rotate. Away we go. Into the wild blue yonder. It's been a decent day today, don't you think?
Yep.
Good. No wind, that really makes it a nice day. We got time for what? Two more?
Yeah.
Two more. Tra la 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 la. Tra la 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 la. Tra la 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 la. 1100 feet right about now.
Challenger 2 November Papa, left turn Echo Kilo to signature maintenance frequency.
Echo Kilo, stay with you, 2 November Papa, thanks.
Mile from the runway, right?
Yep, that's good right here.
They don't have any kind of de-icing machine for the runways?
They put some glycol or something on there.
Yeah.
Executive Tower, 01 Golf, requesting a short approach.
Short approach?
01 Golf, make short approach, runway 16, clear for the option.
Short approach approved, clear for the option, 01 Golf.
Jeez, thanks. Thanks a lot. Thanks, buddy. Thanks. Thanks for screwing me up. Thank you, I appreciate that. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks for fucking up my day. Damn it. Why'd you do that? God, I hate you. God damn it. Why the hell did you do that?
Where are you going?
I went for the number. For the number. Short approach. And I see that plane down there.
Don't go too fast. You're going to... How about the flaps? You didn't use any
flaps. No flaps. We didn't do flaps last time.
Yeah, you did flaps last time. You're not going to make it.
Go around. Executive Tower, go around, 01 Golf.
01 Golf, make left traffic.
I'm ready.
Yes. Why did you do that?
You probably would have made it if you dumped your flaps. If you would have brought all your flaps down, you probably would have made it.
Last time we did, I remember when we did
it. Well, you got to use the option. You got to see what you have to do. If you're too far out, then you wouldn't put your flaps down, right? Because the flaps are going to slow you down.
Last time we did this, there was no flaps, so that's what I remembered. I didn't want to put flaps down when I wasn't supposed to put flaps down.
Well, you got to judge. You got to use that as a judge. You got to judge that. If you're going to need flaps, you put the flaps down. If you don't need flaps, you don't put the flaps down.
Okay.
If you're far away, you're not going to put flaps because you're not going to make it to the runway. But if you're right on top of the runway, and you know you got that runway made, you dump the flaps.
Are you under that again?
All right, if you want, yeah. We'll do it.
Unfortunately, I think we should do that again.
All right.
That's 01 Golf, same intentions?
Yes, sir, same intentions, 01 Golf.
But no, tell them you want to do it.
That's 01 Golf, same intentions.
Same intentions, yeah, I'll talk to them. I'd like another short approach.
Says 01 Golf, make short approach, runway 16, clear for the option.
Short approach approved, clear for the option, 01 Golf.
All right, when I get a beep, my number is carpeed in.
I'll
cut Executive Tower, Skyhawk 872.
That's my job.
All right, do your job, go ahead, do your job.
Good job is to fly the plane.
Yeah, that's what you think.
Cessna 87 Juliet Alpha, Executive Tower, taxi up to and hold short of runway 16.
There's a plane at the 16 pad.
We'll hold short, runway 16.
All right, do your thing.
I don't have to do it now. I do it whenever I think I want to do it.
When do you think you want to do it?
I'll just fly the plane.
I'll fly the plane.
All right, I'll do it now.
Thank you. Go for the numbers, go for the numbers, go for the numbers, go for the numbers.
Okay, what do you think? How do you think you're doing here?
I think I'm hitting the...
Okay, dump your flaps, because you're right on top of that runway. Okay? You're right on top of it. Bring them all, and keep that nose down. Dump all the flaps. See, I got all the flaps down. Okay? Now, what else could you do? Flip it, right? You're high. You're going to come down, and you're going to use right rudder.
Okay, enough.
All right.
God.
All right.
Enough already. Jesus Christ.
That's what you got to do if you're too high. That comes out in the test. It's going to come out in the test.
Okay, are we going to just keep going or are we going to park?
Oh, you're going to stop and you're going to taxi back.
Oh. Sorry, Pete. No, fuck that. Flaps are up.
Okay.
We gotta keep going. No, we gotta
go to the next one.
Yeah, we can't. Yeah, we couldn't have done that.
Taxi back.
Says 01 Golf. Kilo 3, Kilo, taxi back, remain this frequency.
Kilo 3, taxi back, remain this frequency, 01 Golf.
Alright.
Let's not do that again.
Why not?
For a while.
That's gonna be in your test. They're gonna do the same thing.
Cessna 7 Juliet Alpha, turn right northwest and right 16, clear for takeoff.
Skyhawk 87 Juliet Alpha, clear for takeoff, runway 16, we'll turn northwest.
come out right on your test. They're going to do the same thing. Okay, he told you could taxi back. Go ahead. Gave you permission. They got everything okay here?
Yes, yes.
It's on standby.
Yeah, I know it's important. I don't have to like it.
Now the slip, you're going to demonstrate one too. You're going to have to demonstrate
it. It's just counter steering, right? That's like aileron's one way and then rudder the other way.
Yeah. You're going to, aileron whichever way you're coming in. And in this case, we're turning this way, so it makes sense going this way.
And then right rudder.
And then right rudder. Okay. And that's going to, you're going to drop like a rock after when you do that.
I bet.
You're going to lose a lot of altitude. That's one way to lose altitude.
There he goes.
If you go with Dave Koplesh,
yeah,
he's big. He loves doing that of those.
I know.
That's all he does is
slips. Yes. Loves
a short field lane. A short field lane.
Okay. Right.
Short approaches.
That's what it's called. Short field approach.
It's called a short approach. Yeah.
A short approach. Okay.
Soft field and you got to know soft field and short field takeoffs and landings.
Uh-huh.
01 golf, runway 16 clear for takeoff.
Runway 16 clear for takeoff, 01 golf, thank you. I got it, don't play with the pedals, I got it. I think this will be the last one. What time is it? Oh, we got time. Here we go. Rotate. Right into the sun. Good job. Right into the sun. The same thing as before, we're going to get off at K2.
Wherever you wind up.
Wherever I wind up. I beam the numbers, carp heat in. Throttle at 1700.
flaps 10 degrees. Degrees of flaps. Runway's acquired, pitching down, 10 more degrees of flaps. We're gonna turn off. We're gonna turn off to do another one.
Yeah, no, you didn't you say that's it?
You tell me, we've been up
an hour. Yeah, that's fine with me. You could go back, just get off and then tell them you want to taxi back to hop to area 2.
Okay. One red. Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, coming for full stop landing, requesting area 2.
Golf, runway 16 clear to land.
Runway 16 clear to land. Oops. Too low, too low. I got it, don't worry. Got it, I got it. Screw that one up, I know.
Yeah, 01 Golf, Kilo 2, Kilo Echo Bravo, cross runway 24, remain this frequency.
Kilo Echo Bravo, cross 24, 01 Golf.
Good job.
Thank you, sir. He's giving me clearance. Kilo Echo Bravo, cross 24, 01 Golf. Hey, that's me. I'm sorry, I fucked that one up. I'll tell you what I did. I'll tell you what I did wrong. I'll tell you what I did wrong. I was too high.
That's it?
I was too high.
You're flaring out too high?
Yeah.
And what happened to the plane just sunk down too.
Yeah. Shame on me. Are you sure you want to be flying with me?
Sometimes I wonder.
Yeah, I wonder too. Kilo Echo Bravo, cross 24, area 2, 01 Golf. That's me. Hey, that's me. I think they like me. I think they know that I'm really, really trying. Now we're on Kilo, and we're looking for Echo, and then cross 24 Bravo, area 2. I know when we're around this place.
Hello. They give you credit for trying.
Yay, I get credit for trying. Not much else. Trying, yes.
E for effort.
E for effort. Hey. Not a bad day. Not a bad day. Kilo Echo Bravo Crusty 4. At a jog. At a jog. Don't be too eager to go. Ain't no traffic. Blah, blah, blah. This is Charlie looking for Echo. Kilo Echo Bravo Crusty 4. Crossing. British Crusty 4. I see nobody in 2-4. But this isn't 2-4. It is 2-4. Kilo Echo Bravo. This is Bravo because it says Bravo. And this frequency. Yes. Indeed. Now that windsock is that's not putting in any effort.
That's why your landings are better.
Say what now?
That's why your landings are better.
Where are my landings better?
Your landings were good because there's no wind.
Yay, no wind, yay.
Except for that last one.
Yeah, that last one. I knew. Hey, Hey, any landing you can walk away from is a good landing. That's what I say. I have this flight instructor. He doesn't like that. He likes excellent landing. Can you figure that? Excellent landing.
I don't blame the guy.
What the hell is an excellent landing?
Look at the tail. It's on the ground.
Whose plane is
and
that?
And the nose is all up on the air.
Whose plane is that? That's not one of
yours. That's a good picture right there.
Okay, so one moment, please. One moment. Getting ready to park, park, park. Plane.
Oh, that guy abandoned that plane.
I'm sorry to hear that. I'm sure that hurts the plane's feelings. One moment, sir. Reline this baby up. Boom shakalaka. Okay, so carpet center flaps are up. Time for the close checklist. Transponder, goodbye. No ground control. Screw that. Shut down. Nose will straight. No radio electricals are off.